Last year we said we brought a knife to a gunfight. This year I think we brought a bazooka, which is kind of like shoot and just hang on.
This thing is ridiculous, hey?
I always think 18%.
Yeah, 18%.
Hachiju percent. But he, no, 100%.
I don't know 80%.
You're gonna take it for some laughs.
You heard it. It's hard enough maintaining and fixing my own stuff.
Oh,
like
yeah,
breaking
yeah.
Everyone
else. You can just send it and I'll fix it.
Yeah. 5 minutes. We're not gonna fix it in 5 minutes. Yeah.
This is a hectic way to qualify, bro.
Well, thank you.
Woohoo! Sydney!
Well, that's really exciting because we are now in Oil Time Attack, and so is Bullet. So now we get to unload it.
Hey,
how are you, bro?
Good
morning. How are you going?
It was a stressful day yesterday, that's for sure.
Far out.
But we made it. I mean, this thing was in the harbour. Well, we couldn't get on the plane because the planes were delayed. The ships were delayed in Sydney Harbour, so we couldn't even get the container off the boat. This weekend we're doing Time Attack and drifting. I don't know if you guys saw my Instagram. We did a vote, and do we do drifting or do we do Time Attack? Of course I wanted to drift because that's what I really enjoy, but of course this car's already set up for like Time Attack style with the records that got at Pikes Peak. Though Instagram won drifting, Facebook more votes were saying that we want to see a Time Attack. Quieto and the team have got to transform the car, not just for one day for Time Attack and the next day for drifting. It's actually, it will alternate throughout the days from the Time Attack runs. The drift demo runs. Back into Time Attack. And then drifting at night. The least work that the guys need to do to the car, the better, the easier it will be for them. The main thing now is this thing is now full drift steering. So we've cut all the steering out of this that was in it when we ran at Pikes Peak. And now it has Part Shop Max. They've 3D scanned the whole front whilst this was in Australia, whilst this was in Japan. No, whilst this was in USA straight after Pikes Peak. Part Shop Max scanned the whole front end. We tore everything out that we ran Pikes Peak with. And then now the full steering kit's all Part Shop Max. So it's got ridiculous steering lock. I've only done 2 drift laps at Suzuka Twin when we went and tested the wagon at the start of the year. Minimal laps, but it drifts really good. It's got enough power. It's set up for Formula Drift rules, so steering is going to be very nervous. That's something we can't really change. You know, I would put a lot of input and have very minimal rate to angle. Now, small input is massive rate to angle, so it's going to be very nervous, twitchy Time Attack car. But I mean, mate, we're not here to set any world records. I don't think this car is actually capable of setting a world record with the aero, because the Mazda factory deal with this car was it still had to essentially look like the silhouette and have the aesthetics of the brand new Mazda 3. The rear, we can't change anything in alignment because this car was factory front wheel drive. So the rear, it runs a full I-beam across the back, and then Quato's modified that. So we've got some drive shaft sharp hubs, which are splined. So now it doesn't matter where the car's sitting, where it's squatting, it's zero camber the whole time. So it should be a huge, huge advantage for the drifting side of it. But the disadvantage is we can't actually dial tow in. It is what it is. Tuning wise, power wise, will be exactly the same. I'm not changing a thing there. Though it looks like a 4-door hatchback and very small in photo, it's actually got a longer wheelbase than my RX-8, which is longer than all the S chassis, longer than Skylines. This is actually a really big car. It's over 1500 kgs in weight with the iron block 4-rotor, 2 big Garrett G40s on it. Like it is a big car. Just go out there and I'll just try to come one with it as fast as I possibly can. Just I've got to do 2 things. So one, I've got to drive it really wild and dynamic for drifting, and then Time Attack, I've just got to be nice and polite but really fast.
Very excited.
Yes.
楽しみです. Yeah.
Yes. Lots of work for you?
Not so much. Yeah, easy.
Easy?
Yeah.
Oh, my man.
Yeah, he can drive any setting, I think.
Tatumo, 楽しみです.
it's always cool to come to Australia with the rest of the Kiwi gang. It's usually a different couple of guys each year. A lot of them, it's their first time overseas. You know, we've got Daigo Saito, we've got, you know, a lot of the top guys, Yokoi out of Japan. But no, it's good for them and the teams to come and experience it all, and at the end of the day, have some fun with our incredible sport of drifting. Oh, mate, this is Kuwaito, bro. He honestly is the one guy that can just do everything. He does, like, from the wiring, with the fabrication, engine building, the fiberglass is all him.
Shop.
Yeah, and it's in a tiny little freaking shop up in the hills of Kobe. And I built, this whole guy was done in 3 months. Just the man. He really is magic. I've got a meeting, practice.
I want to do time attack test just to Australia.
Yep.
And then night time to drifting, but not too much.
Yep.
No hard push.
Yeah, yeah. No hard push.
Hi. I always saying 18%.
Yeah, 80.
80%.
80%,
80%. Oh. But he, no, 100%.
I don't know 80%.
We need lock the axle pedal.
Tony's out getting some premix. We'll get this thing fired up. Tech has just opened about 15 minutes ago, so we're going to take the car down, roll it through tech, see what we fail on. I think all we had was, that I know was in the rule book that we didn't have, was a brake check light. That's now on. Get a little bit of a fail checklist and then we can change that stuff. And then we'll be into a couple of meetings. Then we've got time attack testing and then drifting tonight from like 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock. So we're going to be able to shred through a lot of rubber. So looking forward to it. Feels good.
Good?
Yep.
Yeah.
Just a gear ratio change. The steering is a little bit, sometimes goes very stiff.
Okay, okay.
So maybe just check the fluid.
Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes soft and then
sometimes. Okay.
And maybe just double check the brakes.
Zero.
Yeah, much better. But coming down here, one pump. Whoa!
Out of gear and going down the straight. Like not even quarter of the way in and I'm top of six. Like, so we definitely gotta change gear ratios.
It's a lot of work for one lap, right? Sorry, the steering was like binding up a little bit. or just getting notchy, and I don't know if it is fluid. Water temps were through the roof, but we didn't have our water squirters going. It was really just a shakedown lap, so it is quite nervous now. And when you're wanting to just do a slight change, man, it does a lot. So it kind of makes it, you know, coming out of any of the corners, it's good that it's got a lot of steering lock to catch it, because it's so nervous. But yeah, it feels good. Fuck, it's exciting. It's the first time doing the first turn. As I come around, the corner just tightens and tightens. And of course, we don't have that much aero on the front of this car. And plus in one lap is not enough time to really bring up the tires to optimum temperature. And it just started understeering, and I was, the more turning I put into it, you could feel it like starting to chatter and want to understeer more. I was like, whoa, and the like bounce on the dirt across the rumble. So that was exciting, the first lap, but yeah, it's gonna be fun. And fans are gonna enjoy it because it's a friggin' loose lap. I feel like it's crazy that we ran that up Pikes Peak. Last year we brought a knife to a gunfight. This year I think we brought a bazooka, which is kind of like shoot and just hang on. Yeah, I don't know, we'd have this discussion now whether we change the ratios and try and make that work for the drifting. Now it's like a 5.2 in there, so I reckon even if we went to a 4.3, we could try that. Yeah, if it works for the drifting, then that's awesome.
Today, 4.3. Tomorrow, 3.6.
Okay. So what Quato's saying here with the gear ratio, so we got quick change, these two gears literally slide on the back of our diff as such, like this. So this one that we're putting in is going to be a 4.3. However, if we slide these onto the exact same shafts but the other way around, that'll take it to 3.6. we'll still be able to use this. Hopefully this will be our gear kit for the whole weekend, so we'll run Time Attack with a 3.6 and then 4.3 for drifting. Time Attack car here that's brought spare axles. Sun's going down. So we're testing tonight, first shakedown run on the drift section. So we've just had a quick driver's briefing, run through the judging. So it's a very different format. It's a qualifying. This year they've put us into pools. There's, I think, 6 or 8 drivers in each pool, and you've got to battle every single person in that pool. And then the two winners, I think in the final, then they go on to the next day. Just means a lot more tandem. The disadvantage of that is we're in a car that we've never actually really drifted. Big challenge for us tonight, but we'll just go do our best and yeah, have some fun.
And they just add the points up, the two people with the highest points.
Yeah, we go through, yeah.
So we gapped it at, some people would say the right time, but we literally just dropped the boxes and had everything. So we're setting up the booth now, so we'll have all the fresh merch. And then yeah, this is a massive fan event for down here in Australia. I'd say this is definitely one of the biggest. Good opportunity to come and hang out and let the fans get some merch.
It was cutting out, so maybe the temperature.
Okay,
because it would keep trying to stall. So yeah, now is too much grip.
Oh, okay.
So maybe tire pressure up and boost up.
Okay.
Yeah, come
much
take
better?
It. Much better.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So boost now, boost up, pressure up.
Yeah, that's good setting.
Okay. Okay, I think.
Yeah,
already,
now.
Yeah.
Yeah, finish.
Yeah, beer time.
Hi. Otsukare sama desu.
Otsukare sama desu.
Otsukare sama desu.
Otsukare
sama desu. Otsukare
sama desu.
Otsukare.
Man, we had an epic day yesterday. We're from first shakedown runs with the car, with the, what was it, the gearing, the tires, like a lot of things. We haven't driven the car for a long time, but it was a lot of fun. And then heading into night drift, it took us about four laps to get a good setting. So obviously the gear ratios we swapped out, we put a 4-3 in the back, and the car felt really happy. Fourth gear through the section. We'll soon find out this morning. I'll get my first run with the new gear ratio of that 4-3 in it that we're running for drifting, which is perfect for the track. Hopefully that's got enough legs to get me down the straight, because yesterday with the 5-2 in it, I wasn't even at the control tower and we're pegging out top of six gears. You know, we're just making drastic changes rather than just little clicks, going from one extreme to the other, and within four laps, and yeah, I feel like, you know, we've got a really competitive package. All caged up now, eh, bro?
Man. Yeah, it's ready for you to take it for some laps.
Woo-hoo, you heard it. It's hard enough maintaining and fixing my own stuff, but like breaking everyone else.
You can just send it and I'll fix it.
Yeah, oh, there we go.
It's PPRE, it's got all the goodness in there.
Oh yeah, that motor, she can last forever,
it's
mate.
It's good, eh, it's good.
Oh, bro, look at that Mad Max thing, brother. Okay, so you can see the boys behind us. They've got the little sleeping bags, tire warmers. So the car's going into those blankets now. There's minimal time between each session. So they'll get those temp. You can see the difference between the R888R and then our slicks. So the slicks now are getting heated. We don't have the luxury of being able to do laps to warm everything up because of the, obviously, the time frame and the schedule. So do as much as we can in the time we have.
Yeah, I will try.
Yeah,
you think?
Yeah, probably.
But this has been...
But if we bend that back, probably break.
We couldn't fix the car, then it would be just do an all-night mission and make sure it's ready for tomorrow's for time attack and the fans. And the car obviously slowed down a lot in front of us, and I said nowhere to go and crash into them, but then they were just saying that Matt had a...
He cut out.
Yeah, the car's broken either way, so... the guys are going to try a wrench on it. It's a control arm. It's actually just talking about camaraderie between the teams, been able to share parts. Unfortunately, no one else has got a front-wheel drive Mazda 3 that's been converted to a rear-wheel drive drift car. So we're out of luck of borrowing parts, but the boys will do the best they can. I've got the best team here. All right, I'm out.
Thank you.
Attempt to start fixing it,
yep.
Whether you finish it or not, you get the points.
Yeah. Right, try to try bend the arm back up straight.
Kurt's old man shop is like 40 minutes away.
Yeah.
And they've got everything they need there.
We'll need that.
Yeah, I know.
We'll get it fixed.
Well, I don't know for the next battle, but we'll get it fixed for tomorrow.
Okay, cool.
Welder and joints.
Cool. Anything you need, let me know. I've got a full shot half of the afternoon.
You good?
Yeah. It's fine.
What happened?
My whole car shut down when I transitioned, went back on the gas and lost power. I had nothing. Yeah.
Are we ready? You can get
this is a hectic way to qualify, bro. Like, one like single pass qualifying is actually, it's quite cruisy. This is, whoa, mate, just trying to get into the show for tomorrow. Drilled him with my wheel, unfortunately the weakest link. Up above had it been just a split second before, it probably would have been our front bumper and headlight that we'd be fixing.
And actually weld it properly.
Yeah, probably.
Do that overnight.
Yeah.
10 people to the Oz DC trailer. I'm not good to see you.
Nice. Okay,
yeah.
Nice done, bro.
Yeah,
thanks.
That's on to KFC, boys.
That pop, it helps because you got more points. More points.
So it made most try points in the board,
isn't it? Should just be a little bit tight on the old stick. Yeah.
Well, we'll press this out anyways. Put it back together as a spare.
Yeah.
And then if we find the new one, find the new one. If not, we use that. We'll have a go now.
Yep.
Is actual reserve drivers set that you can choose from?
Yeah, yeah.
You can't just choose anyone.
There are two drivers you're allowed to pick from. Reserve driver battles and earns us points. So we have two reserve drivers.
Oh, wow.
That can be for any driver.
Oh,
so me, I'm going. Oh,
no, I said you're Koi.
Yeah,
they said, oh, sumo sense. Makes it like a game.
Thank you so much, Zach.
Look, I've got someone else here that's got offering a shop.
Keeping it together, he's now quite nice and
wide.
Taking that inside.
Oh, he's even got SVG's number. Look, it's going to be good.
Obviously, we've got Mad Mike's car in pieces.
Correct.
Has he subbed someone in?
Bro, I'm more nervous for this dude than I am when I'm out there battling for myself.
I feel sorry for the dude.
Wouldn't have been expecting to drive this weekend. Probably thought we were going to be doing some bullshit demo laps.
Yo!
We did say it's one of those things, man. Hats off to all of the drivers who were doing their very best to put on a show here for you. All right, let's just see how we're going. It's got very, very late. In New Zealand, I think New Zealand's gone to bed, to be fair.
Now we're relying on those other dudes to zero out.
Watching in the background,
Bennett
flash.
That was so close, the contact.
Did he hit it?
I think so.
Oh, straight.
It might have just been ever so slight.
Yes.
Here we go. A little love tap. Oh, no, it was there.
that's what it was.
No, he's locked up.
Well, we went three wheels off, so that's zero. A straight line, which is technically a zero. We'll just see what the judges say about that.
Well, confirmed in our ears, Madmike. Yeah. Substitute, Brendan Bennett, gets a win, gets a point.
Oh,
what?
Oh, you! That was the cheapest battle I've ever done, actually.
Yeah,
yeah.
He did good, mate.
Yeah, I reckon he was probably a bit better than you would have been. But
yeah, that's what I reckon too.
I was on radio, was trying to stay with Sammy's, so. Yeah.
You have to trust that the guy in front, except for you and Matty. Oh wait, sorry, still sore, is it? Oh, sorry, my bad, sorry.
Still fixing tomorrow, man.
No, he did.
Hopefully we met on real one.
Yeah, we'll get there.
Just gonna check that guy in my case.
You can see Bullet is back in action. Well, we're about to go into our little shakedown, which is also this is meant to be our time attack session for Saturday. Obviously, with the damages you guys saw from last night, Quiet and the boys did a late night mission, and they've got it back on four wheels. We're gonna have a bit of a shakedown, see how it feels, and then we'll be back on, hopefully. Fingers crossed, she's good to go for tonight's drifting.
The part that sucks when you're mechanically minded and you know what you fixed. I have full faith in the team. Quado doesn't want us doing time attack, so we won't be coming flying down the straight, of course, because if that ball joint did pop out, that wheel's going to do the same thing as what happened last night, and we'd just tear us straight right into the wall. So we're going to cruise around, we're going to feel it out, hopefully do a little bit of drifting, feel the steering, and have some fun. Same as it was before.
Okay.
Yep.
Mentally, I'm thinking about that ball joint the whole time.
Uh-huh.
Because I know it's like popped out, right?
Yeah.
And we've pressed it back in, so it could pop out quite, I don't know, it could last for ages, but one little bump might be enough to pull it out. So I come out of the corner, I'm like, oh, you know, it feels good. And I'm like, nah. Tony will be thinking, he better not be drifting the whole way down the straight. So.
Actually, I don't have any words.
You got no words? What's your thoughts on the weekend,
captions.
Tony?
Subtitles, captions, just make it up.
That's what it looks like from the outside. That looks loose.
The World Time Attack, man, what a weekend, just with all the people, so many fans.
Fun, bro?
Yeah.
For us, World Time Attack Challenge, it definitely was a challenge to have Bullet out there. Really just find a happy medium, but because of the format going back and forth, there's just not enough time to allow the team to go swap all the control arms, move all the steering rack, the brakes, set like the alignments, the gearing. Felt like it was actually really good at both. We had like, this car was never built to get out of the trap like a drag race to the front, which drifting is like that now. You can see we've got a chicane. The disadvantage of having a chicane with just a human that just gives a thumbs up and go is that you still leave at the same time. So usually you'd have a tree with a light, so you can kind of gauge that, because as a chase car, you can actually leave whenever you like. So if you know you're gonna get gapped, you can jump the light, and that you can like just time. So by the second light, you can start rolling off. Where this thing is over 1500 kg, so the hardest part of the entire section is actually just getting off that start line. He was just gone. I like went as fast as I can to get out of there, but as soon as he'd got through the chicane, oh man, I swear he'd pulled like five car lengths before he'd even got to the section. I mean, so I was a little bit shallow. Obviously, I didn't want to go back all the way out to the zone, because he would have just, that proximity would have stayed the same. So I came in a little shallower, tried to close in the proximity. Just, I know this thing with those 20-inch Toyo R888Rs, that would have the grip to send it into the next outer zone. So I was able to close right back up on him there. But then as soon as we got it to the uphill, again, he was just gone. Solid win for him, advancing through. Yeah, so then the last battle we had was with Ben. So just laid down, you know, the most solid lead run I possibly could do with this thing. After, well, crossing the finish with a good run, unfortunately for us, we had lost communication. So I had no comms to the spotter. I didn't know Ben had actually spun behind us, so we were up with a massive advantage there. All we really had to do was just get through the section with no comms and just being gapped by the fastest S chassis at the track, coming up against this other S chassis. As soon as the starter put his thumbs up for Ben, I just started going with a thumbs up, just like I was off. Yeah, then it caught me out. It was a much slower initiation than I thought. So I was kind of side by side. I feel bad because I was kind of like in his line then. And then, so it kind of knocked me. And then, yeah, I just, at that speed, with the amount of grip that we had in this car, I just wasn't able to get it sideways. So we're pretty much straight line the whole way around. So for that way, it was 0-0. So I thought they would then have gone and judged lead by lead. But however, that wasn't the case. Ben went through. But overall, I mean, for us, how competitive this thing was for a car that was set up to do time attack and also drifting. Testament to the team, Coato, and Team TCP Magic. I mean, we've been coming here for longer than 10 years now. Yeah, it's just awesome. We've got to come out and put on a show. And for Baker, bringing out to bring all the different elements of, you know, automotive car culture. You know, you got the car show, you got the time attack, some of the craziest time attack cars from all around the world. Yeah, it was a good time. So thank you, Ian Baker. That's World Time Attack done. These cars are about to go into the container. We are about to hop on a plane because we are heading to USA, where Mad Mac has just touched down. That's down at Napoleon Motorsports in Houston, Texas. So our next project is with Red Bull. We're doing a bit of a filming gig this week, leading into something else in the weekend, which is gonna be pretty exciting. So watch this space.